Hello, this is Julie Harland. Yes, you could actually see me this time, and I am your math gal. So to see all my videos organized by topic, go to yourmathgal.com. And today we are going to be talking about the Möbius strip. There are two spellings. This is the German spelling. It has this German letter we don't have in the English language, an O with two dots over it. And you'll also see it's spelled Moebius. Okay, before doing the Möbius strip and some other cool things, I want you to get some paper and some scissors and some markers that are not permanent markers. These are either highlighters or cheap kids markers. And you can also just use pencil if you don't have anything like that, or crayons, and tape. And you want to make some strips that are about 1.5 inches wide, etc., on the long side of the paper. So go ahead and put the video on pause and make, I don't know, maybe 8 or so of these strips of paper. All right, so here's how we're going to start. We're going to take one of these pieces of paper and close it up so that we have this cylinder. And we're going to take a piece of tape and tape it. And I get a long enough piece of tape so that I can go all the way around like that. Okay? So we have this cylinder. This isn't that interesting, but what do we notice about this? Well, it looks like it has two sides. Like it sort of has this outside and this inside. And in fact, we can define the inside and outside this way. We could say, well, if I start on one side, I could just color it one color, right, until I get back to the beginning. So you just have this. All right, so I see that's the pink side. And then I see there's nothing over on here, so there must be another side. And you can color in here. So I'm coloring this kind of green. You could just do one big long color. I'm kind of doing it all the way through for a reason, because we're going to cut it in a minute. Until I get back, and I have this green side, kind of the inside, and then I have the outside, which happens to be pink. So this is something that has two sides, a pink side and a green side. And how about edges? Well, like, it looks like there's two edges, an edge over here and an edge over here. And in fact, if I take my finger on one edge, you want to make sure it never really touches that. Notice if I go around, I end up back here, it never touches this edge over on this side. So I have two edges as well. All right, so this cylinder has two sides and two edges. All right, now what happens if we cut down the center? So what you could do is kind of fold it and make a cut right here. I hope you're doing this with me. And then think about what would happen if you cut all the way through. So you can put the video on pause if you want to think about it. I don't think it'll take too long to figure out what's going to happen here. Cut all the way through, and what will happen? Oh, well, I just get two more cylinders, but notice it's half as wide, okay? So if this was 1 inch at the beginning, these would each be 1/2 inch. I still have this green side and a pink side on each of them. Okay, so that's what happens if you take a cylinder. Now for the more interesting thing. What about if we start again with a strip, and instead of taping it like this, we are going to take the very top and make a half twist like that. Okay, so here's how it was at the beginning. That's a cylinder, but what happens if I make a half twist and then tape it? What happens here? Be careful taping it all the way around. Okay. The reason why I tape it all the way around is because we'll be cutting it and you don't want it to fall apart. This is a Möbius strip. So when you do that little half twist, you get what's called a Möbius strip. So put the video on pause and make a couple more Möbius strips on your own. All right, so now we're going to try to figure out what are the properties of a Möbius strip. Well, let's start off with figuring how many sides there are. You know, it looks like it's got two sides, but you know, let's just do the same thing. We start somewhere And we just start shading that side until we get back to the beginning. So I just keep shading and shading. So this is the pink side, right? You're doing this with me. If you want, put the video on pause and then come back to it after you've done shading yours. After you're done shading yours. And, okay, I finally get back to the beginning. So I have the pink side. Okay, so let's see. If this is the pink side, let's do the other side. Wait a minute, the other side's pink also. In fact, I have shaded everything. So this Möbius strip only has one side. Wow. Isn't that cool? Now, how did that happen? How could you have a piece of paper with one side? Well, let's see how we made it. Let's say I think this has two sides, so I'm gonna take, you know, I'll think that's, you know, it looks like that would be different than that side, right? So in other words, on this side, at the very ends of both of it, I'm just gonna change. So I could see this is kind of the green side, right? And this is my pink side, right? Before I taped it up. But what happened? So if I tape it like this, that would be like what my original cylinder was. But what did I do? I took the top and I did a little half twist and I just merged the two sides together. So now the green side and the pink side are all the same side. So you could see how that became one side by making a half twist. Now, what about the edges? Okay, so on this first one, we noticed we had, you know, one edge on over here, right? And then this was completely different. Well, what if I said, let me get another color here. I'm gonna say this is edge one, okay? I'm sorry, and this is edge two. Right, that looks like it's on different sides. So in other words, if I had folded it together, this is edge one and this is edge two. Okay, so originally when I just had a cylinder, I had it like that, right? But when I twisted it, see this one merges over here with edge two. So I think there's also going to be one edge. Well, let's just try it. It's kind of hard to do because on an edge, you can't really see what's going on. So I'm just gonna kind of say, well, this over here is an edge right here. It's blue. Okay, and it looks like over here would be a different edge, right? The kind of green. Again, I can't really, you can't see it if I just put it on the real edge. And if you go, you take your finger right here on the blue edge and you go around, don't get a paper cut. You keep going and going and going. You'll notice it ends up over here on the green. So that green is all the same edge, and I keep going and going and going, I end up with blue again. So Möbius strip only has one side, and it also only has one edge. These really ended up being on the same edge. Okay, so that's kind of cool. That's why everyone likes the Möbius strip. It's neat. Now, in fact, it means like if you are an ant walking on this, you're walking and walking, you end up walking forever and ever and ever and getting on really on both sides. If you've ever heard of M.C. Escher, he has a famous drawing like that. So if you look it up on the internet or in a book about M.C. Escher or on a video, you might look at the Möbius strip with an ant on both sides. But it looks like they're on different sides, but they're all on the same side. Okay, now let's do something else that's kind of interesting. So when we did the cylinder and we made that cut down the center, let's figure out what happens here. I'm gonna take the strip and I'm gonna make a cut right here to get it started. And I want you to think about what would happen if I cut all the way through to the center. So put the video on pause maybe and think about that and try it on your own. I want you to cut it through the center and make a guess or conjecture. Postulate, whatever you want to call it, hypothesis, what will happen? Okay, so I'm going to do it. I'm going to just cut right through the center here until I get to this where I started. And I, okay, what's going to happen? Guess. Okay, I guessed the first time I did this that I would get two pieces, just like I did when I cut the cylinder. I would get two pieces. But notice what happened here. I did not get two pieces. I got one long strip, and it looks like it's twice as long, but it's half as wide. So that's kind of interesting what happens when you cut a Möbius strip right down the center. Now, what you can do is find out how many sides, see if this is the same side as the other side. So in other words, is this one or two sides? So if I say this is my blue side, and again, I'm going to do this kind of fast this time. I'm going to go through here. I'm going to see if this is a one or a two-sided object. So I'm going. It's hard because this is long. I got back. You know what? I didn't end up getting blue on that side. So this ended up being two-sided. So it's not a Möbius strip, right? It ended up being two-sided. So once I cut through. All right, so that's one thing that's kind of cool about the Möbius strip. You go down the center and you get one long thing that is two-sided. So when you cut down a one-sided thing, right down the center, you get something twice as long, but it's only one thing and it's two-sided. Okay, let's do something else with one of your other Möbius strips that you have here. And again, so this is one side, one edge. And instead of cutting through the center, let's kind of cut close to one side. Let's say a third or a fourth of the way in. So we'll make one little cut to get started. And I want you to think, what will happen if I cut all the way along till I get back? All right, so before you do it, think about what should happen. Make a guess. If you don't want to see it before you're done, put the video on pause, and I will just keep cutting here, cutting. It's a little tricky. You can do it. Keep cutting. And cutting until I stop, and what's going to happen? Isn't that cool? What happened here? That's the same Möbius strip, but you know what? It's like I cut this much off. I cut this much off. The edge. Of course, there's only one edge. It's the tricky part, so I cut this off the edge. Still have a Möbius strip. So if I would have cut closer to one end, this would just be skinnier. If I would have done it a little toward more toward the middle, it would this part would be fatter. This ends up being twice as long. And they're, you know, linked together. So that's another cool thing. And what you can do, I'm not going to do it right now, is you can figure out whether this piece here is a one-sided or two-sided by, again, taking something and going all the way across. And when you're done, see if you also have blue on what you would think would be the other side. So I'll let you figure that out so you have something to do on your own. Okay, let's do one more thing. Let's, instead of using a Möbius strip, let's create something else. So we started out with just the cylinder. The Möbius strip, I did a half twist. We're going to do another half twist, which means now we've done a whole revolution here. So this is going to be harder to cut. But what happens here is this is back to being two-sided. Remember, each time you do a half twist, you've got a one-sided and then goes back to a two-sided, you know, back to its own side. In other words, look. Take this green, same sided thing. I need blue on the other side, let's say. Okay, so green side only, now green and blue, right? So this is when green and blue are together, I've got a one sided thing. That's the Möbius strip. And then I twist it again, I'm back to only green on one side and blue on the other side. So that's what I've got, green on one side, blue on the other side. And we will go ahead and, yep. This is the tricky part. beautiful. And what will happen, what do you think, when you cut down the center of that? So try that. That's a little trickier cutting. The trick is to get the cut started and then just kind of keep moving the paper out of the way so you can keep cutting down the center. And what do you think will happen? Ah, this time I still have interlinked, but they're both the same width, right? So here are the different things we did. We have, this is my original Möbius strip that I cut down here it is. I think this is one of the Möbius strips I cut down the center. That's when I cut down the center of a Möbius strip. This is when I cut down the center of a cylinder, right? And this is what happened if I have two twists. I'm sorry. This is what happened if I cut off the edge of a Möbius strip. And my last one, this is what happens when I did two twists and cut down the center. And then again, if you want, you can figure out whether this is two sides or one side. All right, so you could make your own experiments up, but basically, the coolest part, I think, is what happens with the Möbius strip when you go down the center. Anyway, and hopefully now you know how to make a Möbius strip. I've seen rings that are Möbius strips, necklaces, lots of drawings. It's infinitely. Okay, have fun.